applications and discussion for future exploration. Thermal inertia-derived soil moisture can be estimated by combining methods as described in sections 3 and 4. An advantage of the thermal inertia method that uses satellite data is that the spatial resolution is a couple of kilometers, which is much more precise than that of the microwave-based method, which has the spatial resolution of several tens of kilometers. However, there are also disadvantages, such as the precision and accuracy of thermal inertia retrieval being affected by the sky conditions, especially clouds, which are the weakest point in using the thermal infrared bands. A recent study showed that the microwave brightness temperatures complemented the thermal infrared-derived LSD, but instead of this, the spatial resolution of the thermal infrared LSD had to be sacrificed. Another disadvantage is that the thermal inertia of a surface covered with dense vegetation is difficult to retrieve. Soil moisture retrieval using the microwave bands also has the same problem. Thermal inertia retrieval over a surface covered with sparse vegetation has been achieved in many studies in which M2018 is categorized in the two-source energy balance, TSEB, concept. In M2018, the vegetation canopy is modeled according to its surface temperature, the three parameters that should be optimized, and the leaf area index, which is given as satellite data. The effectiveness of the TSEB model is not only to retrieve thermal inertia but also possibly to accurately calculate heat flux with regard to the surface heat balance. The denser the vegetation, the less accurate the thermal inertia retrieval. It should be noted that the thermal inertia-derived soil moisture is calculated through a simple TSEB model as well as the surface heat flux, including evapotranspiration. According to the above advantages and disadvantages, soil moisture derivation for a surface is more effective in arid and semi-arid regions where clear sky conditions overwhelm other conditions and where there are spatial soil moisture contrasts, for example, between an oasis and other land cover, as well as significant temporal changes, for example, from just after to approximately 1 week after a rainfall. The optimization scheme for the thermal inertia retrieval is crucial to save calculation time. M2018 uses the downhill simplex method, which is generally suitable for optimizing less than approximately 5 parameters. It takes approximately 20 to 40 s to retrieve 7 parameters including the thermal inertia of one grid in M2018 using a workstation. The downhill simplex method has the advantage of not diverging in the optimizing process, but the algorithm is not simple and requires a long time to complete. A more efficient optimization scheme needs to be explored. Data assimilation procedures are downscaled schemes of microwave-based soil moisture, which has a scale of several tens of kilometers, to one to a couple of kilometers. These schemes have recently been improved using visible, near-infrared, and thermal infrared satellite data, which have more precise spatial resolution than microwaves. These procedures can be competitive with thermal inertia procedures to derive surface soil moisture. However, one weak point with regard to microwave-based soil moisture, Soil Moisture Active Passive, SMAP, was noted, and it was a dry-down process occurred after an antecedent rainfall that was too rapid for in-situ soil moisture measurement. By contrast, the thermal inertia-derived soil moisture agreed fairly well with the in-situ soil moisture found in several dry-down processes, in 2018. This agreement may be because the sensing depth of the surface microwave-based soil moisture was shallower than the in-situ measurement and sensitive to the soil moisture itself, whereas the representative depth scale of the FRM is not as sensitive to soil moisture and almost agrees with the in-situ measuring depth, in 2018. Regarding the spatial resolution of the satellite sensors, an Earth-observing satellite with a more precise spatial resolution in the visible, near-infrared, and thermal-infrared bands, the Global Change Observation Mission Climate, COMC, was recently launched in 2017 by the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA, and the data will be available for general use within 1 year. Its LSD spatial resolution is 500 meters, twice than that of the MODIS resolution, which will benefit both data assimilation and thermal inertia procedures. Another COMC-type satellite will hopefully be able to be operated like MODIS. On the other hand, microwave-based soil moisture can be obtained almost every day regardless of the sky conditions, leading to partial lack of data in some regions due to the satellite orbit. There are trade-offs that have between the above-described advantages and disadvantages of the respective procedures. The Global Satellite Mapping of Precipitation, GSMAP, operated by JAXA is a system that measures the spatiotemporal distribution of precipitation at the Earth's surface on a 0.1 degree spatial scale and a 1-hour temporal scale, and the latest data are added every hour. In arid and semi-arid regions far from rivers, short-term discharge and infiltration should be negligible. Accordingly, the water budget is calculated using the thermal inertia derived soil moisture and XMAP precipitation. Currently, there is not adequate accuracy for both variables to calculate a water budget, but it is worth tackling this issue to estimate regional water cycles and resources. Dust emissions in arid and semi-arid regions have posed serious problems such as soil nutrition loss, crop and vegetation damage, and air quality deterioration. Dust emissions, for example, from Northeast Asia, influence not only individual arid or semi-arid regions but also regions across national boundaries and seas because some dust is raised by strong atmospheric convection and carried by strong westerly winds. Dust emission from the Saharan Desert often harms the surrounding regions, including regions far from Africa. Wind erosion from agricultural land often causes local and regional problems according to tillage practices. To predict these dust emissions in advance, monitoring and prediction of the surface soil moisture distribution over an area where dust emission occurrences are concentrated are important. Scheidt et al. Examined the spatial distribution of thermal inertia for 5 soil types in a desert of approximately 20 km using 8 couples of the daytime and nighttime thermal infrared surface temperatures observed by the Advanced Spaceborne Thermal Emission and Reflection, ASTER, and MODIS, and then estimated the threshold wind speed based on the estimated thermal inertia values after FECAN. The threshold wind speed or friction velocity for dust emissions according to surface soil moisture was examined using carefully designed wind tunnel experiments with multiple soil types, and the threshold friction velocity was found to be related to the soil matrix potential and not aligned with the gravimetric soil moisture for the examined soil types. The matrix potential is not as readily available as the soil moisture, otherwise the function connecting the two variables is known in advance. Considering that it should be difficult to obtain the relationship between thermal inertia and matrix potential, and practical relationships between thermal inertia-derived soil moisture and threshold wind speed with regard to individual soil types are required. In the region where the Earth's surface and subsurface are seasonally frozen, dust emissions begin to occur, early spring, when only the surface is melted and dry but not the subsurface just beneath a thin surface layer. The thermal inertia at the representative depth is still affected by the frozen soil, but the surface radiative temperature is highly positive in degrees Celsius due to the dried surface, which is suitable for dust emission, in other words, high erodibility, if the wind is necessarily strong. The temperature difference was up to at most 20 degrees Celsius, unpublished result. Dust emission is likely to occur in early spring when the meteorological conditions are likely to be windy, however, an empirical relationship between thermal inertia-derived soil moisture and threshold wind speed using observations during spring to early autumn is difficult to apply because thermal inertia is likely to be underestimated in early spring, possibly due to the large difference between the surface and the subsurface temperatures. There is no common formulation for thermal inertia-derived soil moisture with regard to the threshold wind speed in early spring or other seasons. Monitoring the spatial distribution of surface soil moisture over a wide agricultural area is required for optimal water management. An example presented by Minkapia et al. Showed the spatial distribution of thermal inertia over a small-scale cultivated field using airborne thermal images taken in the daytime and nighttime. Root zone soil moisture has been examined in several studies, using a thermal inertia procedure with a from applied to the soil water transport and data assimilation procedures, respectively. All of the studies noted that the initial values of the root zone soil moisture were significant for reducing the simulation error. It was noted that the from applied to soil moisture was not straightforward like the soil temperature because of the nonlinearity in soil water transport that representatively appeared in the Richards equation.